So in this particular video, we will be discussing mainly about the different types of ways in which heat can be transferred. One is convection, the other is radiation. Now we have only studied about conduction. Now what was conduction? How one element of the substance transfers the energy to another, then this energy transfers to another and so on. So there is no motion of the substance, but it's that simply the energy has been transferred from one material, that is from the medium, to the other part, to the other, and so on. So when you talk about convection, there is actual movement of matter or movement or transfer of matter. So this is what you can understand by convection. Now convection, if you want to give a definition about convection, you can say that convection is a mode of heat transfer by actual motion of matter. Now it is only possible in fluids. This is only possible in fluids. Now, why? Say, suppose let's take the example of a boiling water. When you supply heat over here, you will see that from below, you will see that a bit of air bubbles flows up and it's coming to the surface. So this, logically, if you think that this heated matter is flowing upward, this heated matter is flowing upward, and so we can see that there's an actual motion of matter, and this is known as convection. Now what we can observe is that, see what happens over here. Now you know, because of the applied heat energy, there is a change in volume. Because of the rise in temperature, there is a directly proportional, there is a change in volume. That relation we have established. And because of the increase in volume, therefore, by the property of buoyancy, we know that because there is an increase in volume, so it will go up. Because all this matter has increased in volume because it's coming in contact with the temperature, so this goes up. Similarly, if you want to look at the natural phenomena because the result of convection, you can see that during a hot days, you will see that the ground heats up more quickly. And so the air that is in contact is heated up due to conduction. This is heated up due to conduction. And because this is heated up due to conduction, the volume of air increases, and because this volume increases, because volume increases means it's occupying more volume and it has less mass. More volume and less mass will push the heavier objects with less volume to come downward, and this bigger volume will go up. So this is how we see the movement of air. Now let's talk about what is actually radiation. Now there is another type of heat energy, or you can say a transfer of energy because of radiation. Now this is not only limited to your heat energy, but it can be also be any form of energy. Now we know what is conduction, that is you conduct in a medium, you conduct the energy from one point to another. Now you have convection. This is convection, where actual transfer of the material goes or takes place, that is A to position B, this particular matter transferred. Now what about when in outer space you have sun? In outer space there is vacuum, there is no atmosphere present. So how does the heat energy from sun comes to us? Now this is because of radiation. Radiation. Now there are certain waves, that is electromagnetic wave, which requires no medium. Electromagnetic waves. Light is a form of electromagnetic wave. So this light in a form of heat comes to us through radiation, that is the flow of energy without any flow of substance or without any conduction of substance. This is known as radiation. So this is what we can understand by radiation.